Ja, ich weiß nicht, ob ihr es wusstet, aber das Verdauen von Chili con Carne ist nicht die einzige Gelegenheit.
So I don't know if you know, but the chili that we eat with meat is not the only thing we have that we need to estimate how much greenhouse gases we have emit every day. We need to calculate every day what we're actually doing. How much greenhouse gases are we actually giving out? Should I, for instance, take the stairs or should I drive with the automobile? What greenhouse gases are actually produced when I do these things? And with this, we don't actually need to have a very well-developed science background to calculate these things, so we're going to be estimating the effects of these everyday activities. So we're doing a local project about how to talk about renewable energy, and here we're welcoming, and please give us a round of applause.
Ja, hallo.
Hello.
Treibhausgasemissionen einschätzen.
So we're estimating today how we estimate greenhouse gas emissions. So how are we estimating it?
Das fing an bei methodisch inkorrekt und eben gab's auch schon.
So there are methods that are correct that we can estimate or calculate that come from scientists.
Wir alle als Menschen treffen jeden Tag Entscheidungen.
But today, during our everyday activities, all of us are actually making thousands of decisions every day that have effects that are going to be have consequences for the greenhouse gas emissions.
Da hat der Preis eines Produkts oder einer Dienstleistung so ein bisschen signalisiert.
So maybe the price of something is signaling to us something. Where is this product that we're buying coming from? How is it manufactured?
Zahlen bereit bist. Mal bei Ryanair fragen, wie viel denn der Sitznachbar für den Flug bezahlt hat. Das hat doch
also there are questions about if we're taking a plane, for instance, and how is it manufactured, then we're not taking that into consideration. There are thousands of different factors that we consider. That's actually too many to consider.
Und man könnte ein weiteres Kriterium mit aufnehmen.
We can also take a further criterion consider in our everyday decisions. This criteria of how many greenhouse gas emissions, then that actually takes a lot of time to consider.
Eigentlich aus den vom Känguru. Ich krieg's nicht mehr so ganz zusammen, aber sinngemäß hieß es da, wir können uns ja mal überlegen.
We have to think about what is actually going on with climate change. Is it actually happening? Is it not happening? Should I do something about it? Should I not?
Ich bin heute hier,
I'm today here
mit relativ wenig Rechenaufwand
to show you all here how you can then consider this factor without actually taking a lot of time or needing a scientific background.
10 Kilo, 100 Kilo, 100 Tonnen oder vielleicht nur 10 Gramm.
So how much greenhouse gases are being emitted? Are they going to be 10 grams that you're, is it going to be 10 kilograms? How much?
Ist für die Entscheidungsfindung gar nicht so wichtig.
But for the actual decision making, it's not so important how large this is.
Vorweg, was ist denn das hier mit diesen Luftballons?
So here, in front of me, what's going on with these balloons? We have about 11 tons per year of greenhouse gas emissions in Germany. And then we also have
45 Minuten, das ist kurzfristig. Und deswegen habe ich ein paar mehr Luftballons mitgebracht.
Then we have more balloons that we have a collection in front of me here.
Ach nee, das stimmt gar nicht.
Oh no, that's not it.
Die man da sieht, so ungefähr 60 Stück, ist der Zielwert.
So we have in front of us 60 balloons is going to be our goal of how much greenhouse gas emissions that we should make.
Mittelwert, mit dem man sich im Alltag orientieren kann, 2,5 Tonnen.
It's 2.5 tons.
31 Ballons pro halbe Stunde.
It's,
oder das sind so um die 50. Das müsste uns.
It's about 50 balloons.
Ist die Menge an Ballons, die man da sieht, voll mit Kohlendioxid.
And that's full of carbon dioxide in front of us to give us an idea of how much that is.
Es ist also noch viel zu tun.
So there's a lot to do.
Und? Habt ihr Nachrichten geguckt?
Have you looked at the news?
Sondierungsgespräche und so. Es sieht ja so aus, das mögen alle selber beurteilen, aber die Tendenz ist doch so ein bisschen so, dass aus Richtung der Politik.
So right now the tendency is actually looked at more in the politics on the news today. So what is it there to do actually?
Das so ein bisschen hin. Ich treffe Entscheidungen.
In everyday activities, although you do have decisions to make. There are algorithms for every product you encounter. Here's a bottle in front of me.
Man sich überlegen, was ist denn eigentlich passiert?
I have to consider what has actually happened to put this bottle in front of me. It's not so important. There is water inside of it.
Produktionsprozess von Mate mal warm gemacht, also da gab es einen Energieaufwand und dann gehört dazu Mate.
So there's energy, there's matter, there's ingredients inside of the bottle, there's sugar, there's different things to put inside. It probably came from the US. You have to think about how it was transported. It probably came from a ship somewhere. It was then transported by a bus or a truck. The truck came through Germany. And then look at this entire process. You can then think about it and then come to the conclusion quickly. Then the important thing is actually to throw away all the irrelevant information and then come to a decision. What makes a difference? I'll give you a few examples. And then we can make some organization. What is important and then what is not important about this?
Unterhält sich mit seinen Freunden darüber und ist 3 Monate beschäftigt und hat aber immer noch keine neue sparsame Waschmaschine.
You could think about this for 3 months and then talk to your friends about it and still come to no decision about it.
Und dann kommt man zu einem Ergebnis.
So let's look at our conclusions.
So kann das ungefähr aussehen.
So it could look something like this. This is the process that produce in the end, the effect some renewable produced potatoes.
Und ganz am Schluss werden die Pommes auch noch frittiert.
So it had to be grown, it had to be processed. At the end, it was fried, the potatoes.
Die könnte man auch nochmal anklicken. Und dahinter verbirgt
sich. So I can click through this, and then I can look through this process.
Mühsames Geschäft. Und so kommt man an die Daten.
And then in the end we have the data to look at.
Ich habe hier 6 Datenquellen mitgebracht. Naja, eigentlich hier 5. Wir sollten uns die alle einmal angucken. Es geht los mit
6 different data sources.
ProBus ist eine Internetseite und GEMIS ist ein
ProBus is a internet site and it's actually for Windows you can download it and it's open source.
In beiden
in both,
Datenbasis von so ungefähr 10.000 verschiedenen Prozessen.
We have over 10,000 different processes that are saved as data. There's information about potatoes, there's information about truck delivery systems and flights, and what the transportation, all of these different things are saved.
Einfach zu sein.
Actually, this is easy. All these things are categorized, all the data is there. And then there are points registered for each activity. Why are there points and not kilograms? Well, we want a point system so we can then understand how we come to only 100 points a day, and this can be our goal. We have product declarations that are being the data is coming from PDFs that we have. They're very complicated. For example, we have new trains that are running on the train system. So then with every train, there's documentation with it. And we can look at how much energy does this train use and how much carbon dioxide is then going to come out from it.
gibt's Ökobaudat vom Staat bezahlt ganz viele.
There's also some state declarations from the government that has some information with this that we can use.
Gibt's da noch eine ganze Reihe an professionellen Werkzeugen?
There's also professional development tools we can use. We use some things from Switzerland.
So kompliziert und so teuer. Und Physiker anwesend, bestimmt, oder Chemiker.
There's also physical or chemical calculations.
Das ist auch relativ mühsam.
And then it's also not so, it takes a lot of energy to actually make these calculations. It's not so pretty to do. So we have some examples of if you go a certain distance to drive with your car, then you know that you're always going to get a certain carbon dioxide emission that's coming out from it. So we can look at this closer.
So sieht das aus.
This is what it looks like.
Programm aufrufen,
so we're going to call the program, and then we're going to load all the data, and we already did this, so we don't have to wait for 5 minutes like usual.
Was gucken wir uns denn mal an? Ach, was für ein schöner Prozess, eine Flasche Mate.
We're looking at a bottle of Mate that you would drink. So let's click on this and wait.
Es gibt ja noch andere Umwelteinflüsse. Treibhausgas ist nicht alles. Es gibt Feinstaub, Stickoxide.
So at the same time we're looking at we can consider other greenhouse gases, so not just carbon dioxide, where we have nitric oxide, we have other things of then think about what is actually important. Everything comes out, but actually one glass of Mate. So we're looking at the data, what is being emitted from this glass.
Außer Kohlendioxid, die sind nach ihrer Wirkung spezifisch auf CO2 umgerechnet.
This is specifically here only looking at the carbon dioxide, just so it's easier. We can look at the other things. We can click on it, then the orange. And then we're looking at the process chain. We're looking at how much biological material is being processed and balanced. We're looking at
it.
Orange.
Da geht Kohle rein und Erz. Das erzeugt Kohlendioxid.
We're looking,
So we also need to look at the ship that transports the orange. It's made from coal and from iron to produce steel, and you have to factor that into the whole process. It's also really nice to look at cars. The database at for ProBus and for GEMIS, there's a pretty large collection of data for cars. Several different varieties. There's a very long chain of process also involving the mineral oil, and if you look at it, it takes quite a bit longer because the process chain is so long. But we don't have to wait for it. I already brought the results. So, okay, those are the results. This is what it can look like. Okay, we're going to go forward. There's a lot of different means of transportation here. What do you notice? The second and the third bar, those are electrical and diesel-driven trains. I was told today that there's a small train in the Odenwald that uses diesel. That's not really ecological. You can actually drive a bus if you want to do that. Electrical is a lot better. What we also should talk about is the airplane. Everybody says flying is pretty bad. Why would you say that? I mean, it's pretty much the same as driving a car. You can already see here that carbon gas emission, if you calculate it down to the kilometer, then it's pretty much the same. The problem is that you usually go a long way if you take an airplane, but per kilometer, it's pretty much the same. the difference is also that the airplane, in addition, also produces other greenhouse gases that are not taken into account here. So if you factor this all in, it's all about the same as a car. What we should also talk about is this. This is an electric car. If you've been following the news lately, driving electrical cars doesn't solve any problems. It uses electricity made by burning coal, but that's not true. It doesn't help as much as it could, but it still helps. There's already quite a few electrical cars here in front of the Congress. And if you were to actually utilize renewable electricity, then it would already be different. And this, what you see here, is based on the mix that you get from the German electricity grid.
So,
what is it with chili con carne? So, if you eat that, this is renewable because the plants just regrow. So, it's not so bad because it just regrows and you take it, the carbon gets bound again. So, with cars, this is different because you use steel and. If you also look at the bike, a bike has a longevity of about 20 years, so you have to. It's still made from steel and non-renewable energy, but you have to account for the 20 years of lifetime. So per kilometer, it's actually pretty low. And of course, that still means driving a bike doesn't mean you have zero emissions, but it's very, very good, as you see in the bar on the right. Next result, that's also pretty interesting. Since we've been moving forward, maybe we should move up. I actually promised to not have formulas in this talk, but yeah, I gotta apologize, there's one formula in here. So on the left you see going up with an elevator. What does the elevator have to do? For moving up 1 meter, you have to move the person that's being transported, and you also have to move the elevator itself. That's about 330 kilos. Where did I get that number from? Every elevator has to have a ecological declaration that states this number as well. So those 400 kilograms have to be moved up by 1 meter. So we use magic in physics, and we figure out it's 4 kilojoule, or 0.0011 kilowatt hours. What did I exclude in this calculation? For example, the lighting in the cabin and friction and so on. So it's probably not as good as this. I'd say there's about an error of 10%. But I personally believe for a decision you make in your everyday life, you can just exclude that. Just forget about it. So as you already see, the difference between moving up with the elevator and using the stairs is more than 10%, so it doesn't matter. You can just neglect that error. So what's the difference between using ecologically generated electricity in the other one? If you just move yourself up the stairs, it's about 80 kilos that you have to move. If you calculate that, that's 785 joules. So what's the... what's the effectiveness of the conversion? It's about 50% in a human being. So if you calculate all this, so in order to, if you take this into account, you have to actually use about 5,233 joules, which is quite a lot. So this is what it looks like. On the left, that is the version for the beef eater. That's 80 grams of carbon dioxide filled into balloons. On the right, this is the version for a potato eater. And where do you find the version for the elevator user? It's a very small balloon here on the side.
Wasser trinken.
So, let's drink some water. It's also a nice everyday example. If you take tap water, a liter of tap water, that takes about half a gram of carbon dioxide. Where does this number come from? Well, you can already take it from the result. Well, the primary source has to go through the program. Everything's documented, and thousands of scientific studies have gone into those results. But what happens if you drink bottled water? Well, what's the idea? How does the water come to my home? It has to be drilled up from the ground. Yeah. So roughly the same as with tap water. Then it goes into a factory where it gets bottled. You also need bottles. I did a careful calculation, and it's about 20 grams of plastic. So that uses up about 64 grams of carbon dioxide. So it's roughly the same for even if you recycle the bottle, it doesn't get much better, mainly because they rather do make T-shirts out of them afterwards than another bottle. So I decided for calculating the transport cost that it should only be transported about 200 kilometers. That's about 10 gram. So that's roughly the same.
Im LKW transportiert über 200 Kilometer macht 10 Gramm Kohlendioxid aus Dieselabgasen.
He's explaining his calculation again. So I still have to bring it home. So because I'm an ecologically minded person, I do it on foot. So that's about 0 grams. So what can I learn from this comparison? Well, the two variants, the difference is a factor of about 150 between the two variants. So if I made an error in this calculation that has that introduces an error of about a factor of 10, and actually bottled water is still 7.5 grams of carbon dioxide, not 75, then the decision is still the same because the error is just so low in comparison to the magnitude.
What does this look like with balloons? So here in the picture, it's actually not a liter, but this is actually a liter of water that's in the tap water that's in the bottle. We also have this unique chance to look into this this room we have here at the conference.
Letzten Sommer wurde diese Sau durchs Internet getrieben. Schwedische Studie rechnet vor CO2-Bilanz eines.
Here we looked at a study from last summer I read on the internet that Swedish CO2 emissions is actually in electrical autos a disaster.
Ist ein Desaster. Was tut diese Meldung, wenn die so in der Öffentlichkeit verbreitet wird? Das ist jetzt nur beim Fokus, das war ja auch bei Heise.
This was published and spread about.
Lass uns doch weiter mit dem Benziner fahren, die nächsten 50 Jahre, anstatt irgendwas in unserem Alltag zu ändern.
So, how is this actually changing our everyday activity? There's a study here we can look at.
Ja, hier in diesem Vortragsverwaltungssystem habe ich sie verlinkt.
So I linked it here in the presentation.
Das ist schön aufgeführt, das Elektroauto, das man in Schweden am häufigsten fährt.
So in the Swedish electric autos looking, it could also be Teslas. It's based upon batteries inside of the car, and then it's actually not a good thing when you look inside how the batteries are actually manufactured.
Die Hälfte des der CO2-Emissionen der Batterieherstellung sind Strom.
So half of the CO2 emissions from the batteries are actually based from the electrical energy. can look at this table. Here we have an average, and we're looking at the numbers in the chart, and we can look at what happens when the production comes from Sweden, for example.
Wasserkraft ist sehr ökologisch. Da kann ich
you can also look at what happens when the energy is coming from water power. It's very ecologically sound.
Das ist doch schon mal ein Wort. Ich finde auch, mit diesem Fakt,
I'm looking at this fact.
Die Batterie des Teslas in der schwedischen Studie wurde mit chinesischem Kohlestrom gemacht.
We're looking at the batteries that are produced for the Teslas and then being produced from China, and this is one of the worst facts.
Batteriefertigung für Elektroautos in Deutschland sinnvoll oder nicht?
Then we have to ask ourselves, does it make sense to manufacture batteries here in Germany then?
Davon gibt es kein Foto mit Duftballons, das wären irgendwie Millionen gewesen.
And we don't have any pictures here for balloons to measure so much because there'd be too many to show.
Einkaufen gehen.
So let's talk about going shopping.
Streiten sich die Experten, denn was müssen wir vergleichen? Ein Ladengeschäft?
The experts actually disagree about what is good for this example for shopping or not.
Das tun sie erstaunlich oft mit einem PKW.
And we do know that the transportation to the stores usually does come with trucks to the store.
Das ist viel schlechter beleuchtet. Das ist zentralisiert.
There's also an example of Amazon. Some of these factors are then reduced, they're smaller.
But
we cannot make actually useful decision about if this is better or not because there's too many factors to consider. But there's a tendency actually that it's a little bit better online. But then we have to consider, are you actually taking the car if you went to the store? Or are you going to take a bike? Or are you going to walk to the store?
Die Touren der Paketdienste länger werden, denn man kann weniger Pakete auf derselben Strecke ausliefern.
There's also the factor of how many packages are coming to your house at one time. Are they together? Are they separate packages?
Treibhausgasemissionen im Diesel des Paketdienstes.
And then how much per package is how much emissions are actually being done per package?
Lebensmittel auch sehr.
Now we're looking at food that we're buying from the store.
Die sieben Säulen ganz links.
We have looking at the seven columns on the left. These are all plant products, so when you're living as a vegan, then. And what are these ones that have high emissions on the right? What's going on with milk, butter, cheese? Yeah, all milk products, it means there are cows.
Und was man auch
and
sehr schön sehen kann,
we're also looking.
Besteht nicht zu 100% aus Fleisch.
We're seeing that the Wurst, so the sausages, are actually not coming all from meat here.
So kann das dann aussehen.
We can also see.
Das den Speakern oben serviert wird.
This is how it's being served. This is a little piece of bread. We have two balloons. We have the salami. There's not that much meat inside. That's the cheese. There's a little bit more because there's so much concentrated milk. And then here over at the top, there's five balloons. That's a little tiny stick of butter there.
Die Lakritzschnecken habe ich nicht mitbilanziert. Jetzt seid ihr an der Reihe. Tut was.
Oh, and to bring it back to the Tutfats, theme of the conference. What can you take away?
Fahrt wenig Auto. Was ist ein Auto?
Don't drive a car that much. So it doesn't matter if it's an electric car or if it's burning gas. When you do ride with the car, please carpool with other people.
wenig Flugzeug.
When you take a plane, look for this rating of A++++. Also look at when you're going to this, when you're buying electronics, you need to look for these rating systems with the A++. But there's so many pluses because actually B rating right now is already old, so you should only see A or ++++ by the market now.
Und wenn ihr Lust habt, ich habe noch ein paar mehr Luftballons.
And when you still are interested, I have a few more balloons here, if you want one.
Und ich wollte nicht von dannen gehen, ohne mal zu versuchen, diesen Kongress auszubilanzieren.
And I also want to try to balance to make energy neutral this conference.
Aber sind sie falsch genug? Ich würde sagen, man kriegt zumindest einen ersten Eindruck.
Here's the first impression. I did this 2 weeks ago with as much data as I could at that point. We had 3,000 tickets. I was calculating how many people were flying here with the plane, how we were coming with the train or an auto, with a car.
Dann müssen diese großen Räumlichkeiten beheizt werden.
We have all this room here to heat. How much does that use? We have so many kilowatt hours of actually energy being used here for the concerts, the conference.
Vermutet, dass das Ganze mit Erdgas passiert. 220 Gramm pro Kilowattstunde. Kommt 153 Tonnen CO2 raus, nur um es hier warm zu machen.
And you can see the details of the numbers on the chart here.
Nicht so relevant. Und da kommen wir jetzt zu den spannenderen Sachen. 26.000 Liter Mate.
We have so many bottles of Mate that we've drunk here.
Spielt auch keine Rolle. Und die Weltraumfahrt ist ja sowieso kohlendioxidfrei. Macht 1.500 Tonnen Kohlendioxid in 4 Tagen.
So we have this 100 kilograms of carbon dioxide per day that we're using here at the conference. So this seems to be okay.
7 Kilo am Tag ist okay.
Yeah, 7 kilograms. It's okay. 30 is an average.
Damit noch ein schönes Abschlussfoto mit
And here we have a very pretty picture that can
das soll's dann gewesen sein.
Show us the end here.
Noch für Fragen zur Verfügung, wenn dann der Herald noch
da And when you have questions, then I'll stay for the questions now.
Ja, vielen Dank, Gunnar. Also wenn mir jemand noch mal Faulheit vorwirft, weil ich Treppen steige, also weil ich einen Aufzug nehme und nicht die Treppen.
Okay, if anybody ever tells me I'm being lazy when I use the elevator instead of the stairs, I'm not sure what I'm gonna say. We have some time left for questions up until midnight. I'd say we start with questions from the internet.
Frage aus dem Internet. Hi. Wie genau ermittelt man die
How exactly do you calculate the carbon dioxide relevant emissions during the production process?
Es gibt so typische Vorgänge, die hohe CO2-Emissionen verursachen. Das ist immer, wenn irgendwas verbrannt wird.
There is typical processes that happen whenever you have combustion in there, or when you have cement, or when you move stuff, or when you use electricity. Other things that happen in a process change, you can usually ignore, they don't matter. So how do you figure out how much carbon dioxide you get from the electricity, for example, when you produce concrete? That's what we use this software for. So I'm wondering, now when I build a house, for example, there's a lot of materials being used, there's a lot of production going on. Do I have to weigh this, or do you have to calculate this, how much cement I bought, or it's probably on the bill somewhere, or how much wood I used? I'd probably have to weigh quite a bit, but that's how I did it with the speaker lunch. I looked at the packaging of the cheese, for example, and it tells you on the label. So you have to somehow find your own heuristics to find it, or feel a little, try to research, figure out how the process is, or how the production actually works. Many things that you can find in your everyday life, they're already predefined in this software. There was also an entry for beer here, but that's unfortunately not present anymore.
nichts mehr dabei.
Yeah, no, it's not here anymore.
Selbst die Pommes sind ja hier schon drin.
Yeah, but even the French fries are in here. You just have to look it up.
Frage einigermaßen beantwortet.
I hope that answered your question.
Ja, dann würde ich vorschlagen, wir machen weiter mit der 1. Deine Frage.
Ja, vielen Dank für den Vortrag. Also,
thank you for the presentation.
Du hast von V-Auto, von E-Auto gesprochen. Ich bin seit 5 Jahren begeisterter
Erdgas. Talking about cars earlier, and I've been using natural gas for the last 5 years enthusiastically. I want to know now, is it actually better than electric cars? And then, right now we have so many electrical cars on the market.
Caddy Maxi. Also, vier Kinder passt nicht in einer.
And we also need something that has a lot of kids to fit inside the car.
Okay, so let's have a look. It's a Caddy Maxi. Hope it doesn't take too long.
Die Frage wäre auch gewesen, ob du überhaupt so geguckt hast, sozusagen.
The question was, did you even have a look? It's a relatively rare alternative solution. I did take a look. The natural gas is somewhere in the middle between the electrical car and the electrical cars.
Ich meine, bei Erdgas auch. Das fängt damit an, woher dein Erdgas kommt.
And then, of course, it also depends on where the natural gas is coming from, right?
So you can see here it's 300 grams per kilometer.
Konventionelle Erdgas ist.
Wie wär's mit Bio-Erdgas?
So how about ecologically produced natural gas?
Naja, egal, okay. Wollte ich nur anregen, vielleicht als Alternativ gucken, für manche Leute...
I also wanted to look at, is this actually an alternative to consider?
Vielen Dank für deine Frage. Die nächste Frage kommt von Nummer 5.
Thanks. Oh, ja, danke für den Vortrag.
Thank you for the presentation.
Auf deiner Ergebnisliste waren auch Pommes zu sehen und die waren relativ tief.
We're looking at the process for the potato chip, french fries.
Das waren Tiefkühlpommes.
Okay.
Yeah, those were frozen. So here's the intermediate result. This is a biologically produced carbon gas. You can already see this is a lot better than the one result that we had before.
Hallo, vielen Dank für deinen Vortrag. Fand ich toll.
Thank you. I think the presentation is great.
Und mache das jetzt seit 1,5 Jahren.
So I'm a really enthusiastic electric car driver.
Wenn es auch aus diesen Ökostrom hergestellt wird, die andere Frage vergessen oder was
thinking
man
about
halt
when it's ecologically produced electricity. I'm trying to get everything 100%. How is it possible to get electrical generated energy from the tank, the station? What is actually a good or bad goal to have for how much emissions you're reaching?
Well, obviously your goal should be nothing. But yeah, no one really likes strawberries from Spain. For one, they don't taste very good, and on the other hand, they also come here by lorry. But if you and strawberry every now and then is okay, don't worry. It's a lot better than flying to New York for your holiday.
Vielen Dank für deine Frage. Dann hätten wir wieder eine Frage aus dem Internet.
Die Frage ist, wie kann man die vorgestellte Methode zur Entscheidungsfindung noch weiter vereinfachen, um sie wirklich alltagstauglich zu machen?
So, how is it possible then to consider these different things at a day-to-day basis?
Der funktioniert auf dem Smartphone und ist echt simpel.
There's actually an app for your smartphone that you can use that is a lot simpler, that you can use. I mean, you have to trust them that they're doing it correct, but trust me, it's a lot easier. If you trust them, it's great. It's so simple.
Danke für den Vortrag. Du hast gesagt, wir sollen in Passivhäuser ziehen. Ist das nicht gerade auch ein kontroverses Thema? Weil ich kenne
you were talking about having reacting passively. Is that for passive energy? Isn't that actually a controversial topic right now? So, for instance, when we look at the houses that we have available, You have to compare it to a conventional house.
Ja, das ist kontrovers.
Yes, this is a controversial topic.
Ich selber wohne in einem EKFW-Effizienzhaus 55.
I personally live in a certainly in a certain energy class house, and it's tricky. I only heat it up for showering, for example. I can't on the spot here judge what was happening in that specific house you mentioned. The passive houses are usually overwhelmingly positive. When you calculate it, you have to think about it. When you have to construct one of those houses, you have to invest quite a few things like more insulation, and then you get into different factors like when does this amortize? When is that upfront cost amortized over the lifetime? Usually speaking, those are months that we're talking about, not years or anything. So what you save over the first few months is already offsetting the extra cost.
Ich würde gerne wissen, warum du bei dem Aufzug und Treppensteigen.
I would like to know why.
CO2-Ausstoß des Menschen berücksichtigt hast, aber zum Beispiel bei dem Supermarkt.
When you're comparing. You're comparing the taking the elevator and then taking the stairs, and then later you're saying something different when you go walking to the grocery store.
It turns out the potatoes you use when you walk up the stairs, that's basically renewable, so it doesn't actually count. So maybe we should have discounted that. But when you look at the production, well, of course, it's not completely zero because you use like agricultural equipment, but overall, you can just neglect it.
Warum ist EMIS nur als Binary für Windows erhältlich und gibt es Ansätze, da irgendwie eine Ersatzsoftware irgendwie frei zu entwickeln für die Daten auszuwerten?
Why is the result you're giving actually binary, yes or no, when the program you're using can be edited and made more complicated?
I'm sorry, I don't know about that, but it's just the way it is, and I'm not aware of any alternative that are being developed right now. But overall, you can always use the website, and that's. I don't think there is, I don't believe there is any open source software alternative, and I'm not a programmer, so I can't help with that. But go ahead, just make one.
Ganz kurze Frage. Da war dieses Balkendiagramm mit den Lebensmitteln.
There's this diagram for the food you can buy. With what factors was that calculated?
So, yeah, it depends. So it's not just different when you eat a kilo of bread and if you eat a kilo of beef. It's not just taste different. It's also that you take in a lot more energy if you eat the beef, of course. You should account for that.
Ich frage mich, wie du bewertest sozusagen diese Null-Energiehäuser oder Passivhäuser, die im Standard nicht für Hochbauten.
I'm asking myself, how you actually rating the zero-energy, zero-emission houses.
Und da erlebt ja auch Beton sozusagen gerade so ein bisschen Hype, obwohl.
There's some hype right now. Considering is a house made out of wood, for instance. What is your opinion?
Was sind da sozusagen die idealeren Herangehensweisen an die Beurteilung?
What is actually ideal?
Geben wir nachher noch was trinken?
You want to have a drink later? A short answer. I admire. I have great admiration for what architects and engineers construct with. Skyscrapers made out of wood, that's really impressive. But in your line of question, there are so many parameters. Well, for example, if you have denser living, maybe you need less transportation, so that saves quite a bit. Can you then use more concrete? But I'm really glad that you don't buy a house every day. So.
Deine Frage Nummer eins. möchte auch nochmal gerade auf das Beispiel mit dem Aufzugfahren zurückkommen.
I would like to look at the example again of the elevator. And what is more environmentally friendly compared to taking the stairs? And we also have to think about what we're eating and if we exercise, and is that environmentally friendly?
Of course, I'm not. Of course, there are different criteria. There's euros, it looks good, there's emission gas, and there's obviously the criterion of being healthy. So yes, even walking the stairs, half a balloon, like that's 2 grams, doesn't matter. It's completely okay. Oh, phew. We're lucky.
Nummer 5, eine Frage von dir.
Gerade auf dieser Folie habt ihr vom
Right off this slide here, there's general commentary. We're talking about production energy from the food that production. What are there activities that are improving there?
Das können wir noch nicht.
A general.
We can't really change the efficiency of natural processes, but we have done that. For example, the way we generate electricity, there's still a lot of combustion involved, and there are physical limits, like, for example, the Carnot limit. There's a difference between the temperature in your power plant and the one in your environment is your maximum efficiency. So now you could try to increase the efficiency by lowering the temperature of your environment, or you can just burn hotter. So this is basically, we are at the limits where this is still possible to be improved, because we're at the limits that are given to us by the materials that we employ. We are already very close to the physical maximum of the efficiency. Maybe a few percent that we can still get there, but there's not a lot of jumps to be expected there. I don't see a lot of things that you could change here. So this is not going to make the change that we need.
Ja, vielen Dank. Damit sind wir am Ende des Vortrags angekommen.
Thank you very much. We've come now to the end of the presentation. Thank you for listening to Celeste and Gaste. You've been listening to